Be perfect as your heavenly Father is perfect. Welcome to the 10th day of a journey from wilderness to Calvary. My dear beloved God, in today's gospel we find a discourse which was preached by Jesus on the mount. There were so many discourses that Jesus gave, but we only find in today's gospel Jesus telling us, be perfect as your heavenly Father is perfect. With regarding what Jesus is asking us to be perfect as his heavenly Father is perfect. Yes, he is asking us to be perfect as his heavenly Father is perfect with regarding to loving our enemies and praying for those who persecute us. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, before we get into the details of today's gospel, let me tell you a small story about a man called Samuel who was serving the church voluntarily. And as years went by, he was so dissatisfied that he felt that he was doing nothing to God. And then he went onto the streets and began to love the people by serving them, taking care of them. And all of a sudden, an angel appeared to this man and asked for the address of Susanna, Joseph, Samuel, and another person called Daniel. And when this angel was, when this Samuel was accompanying the angel to these places, Samuel asked this angel, why are you visiting these members? Why did you ask for the address of these people? And the angel said, you know, God asked me to find out the people who love God and to meet them. Samuel was so disappointed because his name was not in the list. And later on, this man went to sleep with a lot of disappointment. Following day, again, the angel appeared to him. And now this man, with a disappointment, he went to the angel. Now, which addresses do you want me to tell you? And the angel said, you know, why did you come? The angel said, you know, yesterday it was God who said, find out those people who love God. And today God has sent me to find out people whom God loves. And your name is the first in the list. Well, my dear brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, Samuel loved the people without any selfishness. And therefore, he was in the first list of God's eyes. And today, Jesus invites all of us to be in his list, to be the forefront. How? By loving our enemies and praying for those who persecute you. In the Greek language, the Greeks had a four kinds of love which was expressed. The first one is the eros love. This love is born of sexual attraction, or what you call is of sexual love. And the second kind of love that they believe in is starch love. And this is the love that arises from an affection, which is just like an example of the father and the son. And the third kind of love is the philia, the love which is more of deep affection, which is born of intimacy and a warmth and tenderness and preciousness. This love is just like Peter's expression of his love towards Jesus. And the fourth kind of love, which is the most important of all, is the agape love. This love is that which demonstrates kindness. It is sacrificial and love that cares, gives, and works for another without any selfish motive. And this love accommodates everyone, irrespective of whether he is good or bad. And Jesus means to say today, love your enemies and pray for those who persecute you. Well, my dear brothers and sisters, this is the love that Jesus was meaning to love with love enemies, irrespective of how cruel he is, how bad he is, how worst he is. Extend your love. And the second thing that we find Jesus telling us, to pray for those who persecute you. There are so many people who feel that our own family members persecute. Sometimes the wife feels husband is persecuting, or sometimes husband feels that wife is persecuting. The children feel that parents are persecuting. The grandparents, the elders feel that they are not cared for. There are so many kinds of persecutions that we go through in our daily life. But Jesus asked, pray for them. And what is the thing that we have to pray for them? Firstly, pray to God that God forgives the persecutor. And that's why in the Gospel of Luke chapter 23, verse 34, we hear the beautiful words from the mouth of Jesus when Jesus was being persecuted. Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing. And the second thing that we need to pray for those who persecute us is to pray for peace between oneself and the persecutor. What a beautiful thing, my dear brothers and sisters. And third thing is to pray for the salvation or for the correction of the person who is persecuting. Pray to God that he may change and transform his life. And that I think Jesus did the same thing by praying for these Pharisees and scribes who were continuously trying to find fault with him, speak ill of him. You know, they were becoming like a thorn in his flesh. Yet he prayed for their transformation. And that's what we are called to do. Pray for those who persecute us. Well, my dear brothers and sisters, today, and as we are in the season of Lent, let us just recall those moments where we have enemies and we become sometimes the persecutors. And let us also pray for our own selves that we may not become persecutors. And let's also love our enemies. Love our enemies without any boundaries. Extend the boundaries so that God's eye may be on all of us. Amen. If you like this piece of reflection, kindly share, like, and contribute your mite for the promotion of this channel, Liturgy TV. God bless you and have a wonderful day.